I've done that once or twice myself.
It's a real pity about me brother's accident, though. Taking all me cash like that. Just when Mum's birthday's coming up, too.
You can't afford to buy her a present.
No. Oh, but I'll get her something, I'll tell you that much. Right, just between you and me, I reckon there's a lot of easy money just waiting to be picked up. You look at Ernie's cash till over there. There must be hundreds in it. And I'd do it, too, for Mum. Well, she's worth it.
Don't you talk like that. You'll only end up in the slammer. Then you'd only see your poor old mum once every visiting day.
Well, what the hell am I supposed to do? I can't find any work.
Listen, Errol. You're a good young bloke. Any woman would be proud to have you for a son. You've been real good to me, helping me while away a lonely afternoon. I want you to do something for me. I want you to go out and to buy something real nice. Something that your mum would really love to have.
Eh? Now, I can't do that.
Of course you can, and you will.
Jeez. Lady, you're a real mate.
This is grossly unprofessional, Mrs. Morris. We're used to this sort of thing from the prisoners, but we do expect loyalty from our officers.
The officers are loyal to common sense and their own safety, Mr. Douglas. The riot showed just how effective the department was when it comes to backing prisoners into the corner. Now, all the staff want is a return to the old form of security. Now, there have been minor infringements
government
of the rules...
Government departments are run to a system. Decisions are made by persons in authority, not by employees. I'm surprised you let it come to this, Mrs. Davidson.
There was very little I could do about it, Mr. Douglas. I have maintained the department's policy as far as I can, but when it comes down to it, I am inclined to share the officer's decision.
Very well. I'll see the minister about this, then I'll get back to you.
What do you want?
How long are we going to get locked up in here?
Until you let out.
What's going on? Are the screws on strike or what?
That's none of your business.
Pigs, it ain't. We're supposed to get fed, you know.
You will be fed when the food's brought to you.
And when's that going to be?
When there's staff here to serve it.
So the screws are out then.
Mrs. Morris, I didn't expect to see you this afternoon.
Oh, Mrs. Davidson's asked me to prepare a report for your parole board meeting.
Oh, that's terrific. But I thought the officers were on strike.
Well, this isn't officially prison officers' duties anyway.
Thanks, Mrs. Morris. I really appreciate it.
Now, despite your early record of escapes, the various reports put through to the classification committee have shown that over the past few months you've settled down a great deal, and this is why they're prepared to review your case. Of course, you do realise that if you get into any trouble at all between now and then, you won't stand a chance of being paroled.
Don't worry about me. I'm not going to rock the boat.
Good. Well, the first thing we have to prove is that you've got suitable accommodation and a job to support yourself.
Oh. Well, I don't have enough money to get a flat. The only job I've ever done is taxi driving, and I don't know if I'll be able to get my certificate back.
Well, I'll check that out for you. In the meantime, you try and think if you know anybody that could give you suitable accommodation, because we have to give an address to the board.
All right. And thanks very much, Mrs. Morris. I appreciate it. Hey, how long's that strike going to go on for?
Well, I can't discuss that with you, Judy. Anyway, why should you worry? Gives me plenty of time to check out that cab driver's license for you.
Damn them.
What
right do they have to go out on strike? They're public employees.
Yeah, well, so are train and bus drivers, and they seem to get away with it. Anyway, I wouldn't complain too much. They're probably jacking up against the tight security restrictions.
Why should they do that?
They don't like it any more than we do. It just makes more work for them. And they know we don't like it. And they don't want another riot on their hands.
Yes, I suppose you're right. You have a pretty good understanding of people in here. I suppose you developed that over the years. Funny, you know, I never thought I'd end up in a place like this. Shouldn't think anybody ever does. You get the impression of a criminal being some sort of subhuman class. Really quite a relief to find an ordinary, normal person.
Well, hallelujah, the doctor's seen the light.
I didn't mean any offence.
Oh, built up goody two-shoes.
Oh, what have I said?
Skip it.
Toby, tell me. Look, I thought we'd become friends since I diagnosed your complaint.
Oh, yeah. All right. So I'm grateful. But don't go expecting any undying devotion.
What's wrong? Oh, I see. Oh, yes. The great B. Smith can't bear the thought of being in anyone's debt. That's right, isn't it?
Oh, don't talk garbage. Look, I just don't understand your angle. What's in it for you? All this little Miss Innocent sweetness and light floating down the corridors. It just doesn't ring true.
Why won't you trust me? What do you think I am, a spy or something?
Ah, now that's just it. I don't know what you are.
I'm sorry. Nobody else feels that way.
Oh, yes, they do.
Who else? Well, tell me, what am I supposed to have done?
I've just heard a little whisper here and there. Nothing much yet. But I'll wait until I find out more. And when I do, you'll be the first to hear about it.
Birdsworth.
Why? What's the matter?
Why don't you go back to your room and lie down?
Oh, yeah. Good idea.
Mrs. Birdsworth, come on. Give you a hand.
Yeah. Why not?
Up there, come on.
Let's dance. There's nice music. Get him to play the Gay Gordons.
Yeah, right.
Send up a bottle of grog to my room and charge it.
Oh, no, take it easy.
Get him to play the Shearer's Fancy, boys.
That's right, Birdsworth. Time for Betty Buys,
oh,
eh?
Oh, have you know I'm a respectable lady.
There we are. That's
right. I reckon I had a few too many, don't you?
Yeah, right, about 20. There we are.
Oh, God.
Sleep it off now, eh?
Oh. Lights out. Good night, Bee. Good night, door. Oh.
Oh, Mrs. Morris, how come you're working?
Well, the union's agreed to allow 2 members per shift to help out. I got the first shift. Hey, aren't you hungry?
No, I'm too excited to eat.
I phoned the Transport Regulation Board this afternoon, and they've agreed to reissue your taxi driving permit.
Hey, that's great!
Provided it's approved by the parole board.
Oh. Well, what do I have to do to get their approval?
Well, you have to have a job.
Now, isn't that wonderful?
To get a job, I have to have a taxi certificate, for which I will need a parole certificate, for which I will need a job. I mean, I'll be too old to drive the bloody taxi by the time it comes through.